Welcome students in the organic chemistry lecture series. Today in this video lecture we are going to study about the new class of pericyclic reactions, that is sigmatropic rearrangement. Now we'll see first what is this sigmatropic rearrangement. These are just a molecular rearrangements in which a sigma bonded atom or group or a pi electron system shift to a new location or a new position, and thereby we get a reorganized structure in the product. That type of reactions are called as sigmatropic reactions. Important thing which we have to remember here is that the total number of sigma bond and pi bond remains unchanged. Okay, that means the number of sigma bonds and number of pi bonds in the starting material, that much number of sigma bond and pi bonds are there in the product also. Okay. So we'll see some schematic representation so that you will understand what is this sigmatropic rearrangement. See, this is not a reaction, this is just a pictorial representation so that you will understand about what is sigmatropic rearrangements. So see this here, this is a one atom. The position of this atom in this starting material is here attached to this atom, but in the product this group is at this position. That means this is attached to this position. That means what is happening here, the position of this atom is shifted to a new position at this position. So such type of reactions where the atoms or group, sigma bonded atoms or group along with pi electron system takes a new position in the product, that type of reactions are called as sigmatropic rearrangement. And the number of sigma bond and pi bonds in the starting material will be equal to number of sigma bond and pi bond in the product. So this is a sigmatropic rearrangement. Now here 1 comma n sigmatropic rearrangements, the meaning is that this bracket represents the number from where the atom was initially, and next number will be at which number the atom comes in the product. That means this number will be a number where the atom was before a rearrangement, and this number will be the number where the atom comes after rearrangement. So this is nothing but the sigmatropic rearrangements. And generally the atom which moves from one position to another position is a hydrogen. So we call this reaction as a hydrogen shift also. Okay. So depending upon the position, number of position of this hydrogen, these sigmatropic rearrangements are of different types, like 1-3 shift, 1-5 shift, 1-7 shift, like this. So we'll take one by one what is this sigmatropic rearrangements. Okay, now see this. Now in this example, at one position there is a hydrogen atom. Okay, now after rearrangement this hydrogen atom comes to this position and this bond shift here. All these things, that means formation of bond between this hydrogen and this carbon and shifting of this bond, all this process takes place at the same time, that is concerted mechanism. And finally we get this rearranged product, that is double bond, single bond, and then hydrogen here. This called as a 1,3 shift. Now whatever numbering we have given here, this is a different than IUPAC numbering. Okay, this numbering is just to represent at which position that hydrogen was, to just to represent. It is different than IUPAC system. So the hydrogen atom which was at one position, it goes at three position in the product. So this is called as 1,3 shift. Okay, now similarly if we take the example of pentadiene, see what happens. The hydrogen atom which is at one position comes to this fifth position. As soon as this hydrogen atom comes to this position, this bond shift here, this bond shift here, and we get this product, and therefore it is called as 1,5 shift, because the hydrogen atom which was at one position comes at five position after the rearrangement. So it is called as 1,5 shift. Okay, so we'll take another example. Yeah, this example and this example is same. There is no difference, just at this position there is a one substituent, one group is there. So mechanism is same. This hydrogen shift to this position, this bond shift here, this bond shift here. So 1,5 hydride shift takes place. The transition state is cyclic. So you see in this transition state, bond forming and bond breaking all are represented by dashed lines. So this is a cyclic transition state. We call it as a concerted, because bond formation and bond breaking is taking place simultaneously, and finally we get this product, right? So you remember that in every reaction you can draw the cyclic state like this, transition state like this. Now this is a 1-3 shift example, this is a 1-5 shift example, this is also example of 1-5 shift. We'll take another example, that is 1-7 shift. Now here you take the example, how many carbons are there? So it is heptatrine actually. So three double bonds are there, and what is happening? See, the hydrogen atom which is here at one position, it goes to this position, 7 position, via this cyclic transition state, and we get this product. So this is called as 1-7 shift or 1-7 sigmatropic rearrangement. So I think you all understand what is sigmatropic rearrangement, what is 1-3 shift, what is 1-5 shift, and what is 1-7 shift. Now we'll move further. We'll see this very famous reaction, that is a Cope rearrangement. It is the sigmatropic rearrangement. There is a little bit difference here. In this Cope rearrangement, there is a 3-3 sigmatropic rearrangement. Before this slide, we have seen what is 1-5 shift, what is 1-3 shift, what is 1-7 shift. Now this 3-3 sigmatropic rearrangement means what? There is a shift of atom from 3 position to 3 position. Now see this system, see this 1-5 system. If we start numbering from this carbon, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So if this bond shift here, this bond will shift here, and this bond will break to form this 1-5 dime. So this see this two, this starting material and this product. Here in between these two carbon there is a bond formation, and the bond between this carbon is breaking in presence of heat. Okay, so this is a mechanism. You can start from any end. Suppose this bond is shifted here, this bond will shift here, this bond will shift here. This is a concerted cyclic transition state. Concerted means bond breaking and bond formation is taking place simultaneously, and we get finally the product. Okay, so this is a Cope rearrangement. So what is Cope rearrangement? The Cope rearrangement is an organic reaction where a 1,5 diene under thermal condition is converted to another 1,5 diene. That product is a structural isomer of starting material, and this is called a sigmatropic rearrangement, and specifically it is called as 3,3 sigmatropic rearrangement. Okay, so we'll see some more examples of this Cope rearrangement. See this example. This is again a 1,5 system. Now here also see this bond shift here, this bond shift here, and this bond between this 3-3 position will break, and there is a formation of this product. This product and this starting material are structural isomers of each other, and there is a bond breaking between this 3-3 position. So it is 3-3 sigmatropic rearrangement in presence of heat. Now see this example. This is a mechanism of this reaction. Just a movement of electron is shown here. So this bond shift here, this bond shift here, and this bond breaks down to form this product. So this is about Cope rearrangement. So I think you have understood well what is Cope rearrangement. Now we'll move further. Another important sigmatropic rearrangement, that is a Claisen rearrangement. Okay, now say what is Claisen rearrangement? It is similar to the Cope rearrangement. There is a very minor difference between this Claisen rearrangement and Cope rearrangement. So before explaining the difference, I will explain that this rearrangement is first of all discovered by the scientist known as Rainer Ludwig Claisen in 1912. So it is called as Claisen rearrangement. So this is again a sigmatropic rearrangement. What is the similarity between this Claisen rearrangement and Cope rearrangement that we have to understood? So see the starting material. This is a 3-3 system, right? In Cope rearrangement, instead of this oxygen, there is a carbon. That is only the difference. So we can say that in case of Claisen rearrangement, the starting material is allyl vinyl ether. Okay, so this fragment is known as allyl. You know this group CH2, CH, and then CH2. This is called as allyl, and this is a vinyl system. So the name of starting material is allyl vinyl ether. So if this system is subjected to heat or Lewis acid, there is a rearrangement of the atoms to form this gamma delta unsaturated carbonyl compounds, and this is a 3,3 sigmatropic rearrangement which is popularly known as Claisen rearrangement. Okay, so I think just a difference of starting material, the mechanism wise, this Claisen rearrangement is as like Cope rearrangement. So it is a very, very similar to Cope rearrangement, just a matter of differences in starting material. So we'll see some examples so that you will understand what is this Claisen rearrangement. Now here, see this starting material, okay? So this system is a phenyl system. We know this phenyl system. This is allyl system. So what will be the name of this starting material? It will be allyl phenyl ether, right? So if we subject this allyl phenyl ether with heat, there is a formation of this product via 3,3 sigma trophic rearrangement. If we number this groups, then 1 2 3 1 2 3, there is a formation of this product, right? So this is again a sigma trophic rearrangement, which is the example of a sigma trophic rearrangement. So I will summarize finally what is a sigma trophic rearrangement. Sigma trophic rearrangements are the reactions in which atom or group changes its position in presence of heat, and also the position of pi bonds are changes in the product. So there is a reorganization of starting material to form new product. That rearrangements are called as sigma trophic rearrangement. Sigma trophic rearrangements are of different types, like 1,3 shift, where hydrogen is shifted from one position to three position. Again, 1,5 shift, in which hydrogen is shifted from one position to fifth position. Again, 1,7 shift, where hydrogen is shifted from one position to seven position. And then later on, we have seen the two very famous rearrangement, that is Cope rearrangement and Claisen rearrangement. You remember that Cope rearrangement and Claisen rearrangement are both 3,3 sigma trophic rearrangements. How we can understood which is which reaction? You just remember the starting material. In case of Claisen rearrangement, the starting material is allyl phenyl ether. So by observing the starting material, you will easily understood that it is Claisen rearrangement. And Cope rearrangement is also the same, just the simple system is there. So in both rearrangement, Claisen rearrangement as well as Cope rearrangement, there is a 3,3 sigma trophic shift in presence of heat or Lewis acid. Okay, so these two rearrangements are very important in carbon-carbon bond formation reactions. So I hope all of you have understood very easily these reactions. So try to write down the examples of Cope rearrangement and Claisen rearrangements on paper. Try to draw the mechanism so that you will easily understand what is the sigma trophic rearrangement. So for today, we'll stop here. Take care of yourself and study smartly and be happy. Thank you. We'll see you in the next lecture.